Hey, the exams are over. My brain is completely fried. And motivation to study is like -1,000. So just like a normal human being, you would be probably resting. But no. We are going to make a music streaming platform from scratch. Like zero. So let's go. Why? First, because I can. Second, no ads. I don't like. I mean, maybe. Maybe you like ads. Third, it's personal. Like, just make an account, link your box cloud storage, and boom, you have your own music streaming platform, personal, private. However you like, call it. So, let's make it. Okay, so I have transferred my notes here. So the game plan is, you will have sign in and login. It will be your usual dial phone's authentication. Next is link your box account, file system style library. What I mean by this is, you will manage your library just like a file system, like how you used to do it in your computer, right? Beautiful and simple user interface. It should be clean and there should be a touch of personalization. We will proceed to the least buffer part. So what I mean by this, I will try to reduce the buffer as much as I can because I know it will take time because it's going to take from box and then play it in your music player. So it will take few minutes. Playlist, usual stuff, nothing to explain. Settings page, just for basic kind of things. OPFS store. What I mean by this is it's origin private file system. It's basically kind of an index.db kind of stuff. You can save your files and stuff and you can move. But it is in a file system style. You can read, I will link the documentations in the description. The future of this project will depend upon your response after this video. So, some future plans. Global search engine. What I mean by this is, all users have their own library, right? So, what you can do is, you can search, if maybe you want to listen to some music, and maybe you don't have that music in your library, you can search on your Google global search engine. Maybe some other user have that music in their library. You can just directly import that music from his library to your library, and you will listen to it. Of course, there will be a privacy sector. You can basically turn off global search engine anymore. User settings, right? Easy. Next is import directly from YouTube. You can directly download any music from YouTube and directly import it into your library. Easy. Session music with friends. What I mean by this, it's basically an skeleton draw kind of stuff where you can share, start session, share the link with your friends, and your friends can listen to the same library at once. I will release some public APIs for the users if we will have a good amount of user base. I know user base of this kind of an application is going to be very niche. This application is very niche to the very kinky kind of people like me, and I think they will love to use this kind of application. The next point, link your friend's library. What I mean by this, you have your own library, but you can also link your friend's library and listen to his library. Just a normal handshake or kind of stuff. Understand it like this, how it can be useful. Maybe you have a group and there is a person who always maintains his library and you are just fucking lazy as person. You don't like to maintain your library, you can just link your friend's library to your account and you can use and enjoy his library, which is up to date, right? Easy. So I have some basic system design ready for the cassette. So how everything will work is, the main application, the cassette, will be built on Next. Is basically Next alternative for Vue framework. So the main application will be on cassette.dalphaverse.com. Database for this application is going to be MongoDB. I don't know why I've chosen this. I just used, no questions asked. If there will be a problem to this database in the future, like for the user base and stuff, I will change it, right? What will happen is, for this specific app, we have this MongoDB. What will happen is, you log into the cassette, then you connect your box account, and in the box account, you will have to make few directories. First is a cassette. Second is cassette underscore underscore data and cassette underscore data slash thumbnails. And you have to put your music, like every file and folder, everything in this cassette directory. When you will connect your Box account, it will sync your music and index every music from this directory, specific directory. And it will index all the music and save the indexes in this MongoDB. So whenever you are listening to music, it should not always have to like search to your Box account and like redeem it and stuff, right? It will index everything and put it up here, right? And your Box credentials will also be saved here in this MongoDB, right? And the authentication provider is the Alphonse authentication. It's simple, nothing much to tell here. So what will happen when you want to play a music? First, it will go to MongoDB. It will get that music ID. Then it will go to Box. It will get that music by the ID and it will play the music here, right? I have something here also cooking in the front end, and I also want to do a caching layer in between with the OPFS. As I said, first it will see in the OPFS if the music is available. Then it will take the music and then it will play in the front end. If it's not available, it will come to the Box. It will take the music. It will download and save into the OPFS, and then it will play from the OPFS. It will take time for the first time if you're listening to a music, but for the next time it will not take. It's going to be more like instantaneous, right? So this was the major game plan. So, there it is, I wrote it myself.
Would you lay your life down?
So here we are at. Cassette works, no ads, no nonsense, just log in, play your music and you vibe. So let me guide you how it works. So this is my alpha account. If you have one for yourself, you can just straight up log into the cassette. If you don't have, you can make your account and you can log in. For the cassette, we have to go to cassette.thealphaones.com. I will log in the norm.vg, a password. Now, you have to log into your Box account here. Now what you have to do first is create some folders, right? Folder So for the first folder you have to make is cassette. Cassette. Right. Next is cassette underscore data. फिर इसके अंदर आओगे आप एंड इनसाइड दिस यू हैव टू मेक अ फोल्डर नेम एज थंबनेल्स एस थंबनेल्स क्रिएटेड वेयर यू हैव टू पुट योर म्यूजिक यू हैव टू पुट योर म्यूजिक इन दिस कैसेट डायरेक्टरी राइट आई वांट सम इंग्लिश ओके तो मुझे जितना भी म्यूजिक अपलोड करना था मैंने अपलोड कर दिया तो तुमने सारा अपना म्यूजिक कैसेट के अंदर डाल देना है नाउ यू हैव टू कम टू कैसेट अब तुम्हें ये कनेक्ट टू बॉक्स अकाउंट लिखना है अब देखो कभी कभी इसका लिंक ना फकअप होता है ठीक है मतलब ये बॉक्स गलती मेरी नहीं है वो ऐसी बात है तो एक बार वापस ट्राई कर लेना वो सही हो जाता है मतलब अगली बार पक्की बात सही हो जाएगी ठीक है तो कनेक्ट टू बॉक्स अकाउंट राइट ठीक है अब तुम्हें बॉक्स का एक्सेस ग्रांट कर देना है सो ग्रांट एक्सेस टू बॉक्स अब तुम्हारा कैसेट खुल गया राइट अब यहाँ पे ये सारा अपना लोड वोड करेगा जो भी तुम्हारा इन्फॉर्मेशन है एंड यहाँ पे आके ठीक है तुम एक बार सिंक कर लो अपना सारा डेटा राइट एज यू कैन सी डेटा इज सिंक्ड ठीक है तुम अगर यहाँ पे मैं तुम्हें ले आऊँ ठीक है तो पहली बार चलाओगे तो ये थोड़ा सा टाइम लेगा क्योंकि ये म्यूजिक तुम्हारा बॉक्स से मंगाएगा और इसे ब्राउजर के अंदर OPFS में सेव करेगा और उसे कैश करके रखेगा ठीक है तो पहली बार पहले सेव कर लेता है फिर प्ले करेगा ठीक है तो ये थोड़ा सा टाइम लेता है पहली बार प्ले करने के लिए लेकिन उसके बाद से तुम करोगे तो फिर वो आराम से ही चलता है और थंबनेल भी पहली बार जनरेट करता है और लाके सेव कर लेता है और तुम्हारा जब थंबनेल जनरेट करता है तो उसको तुम्हारा बॉक्स के अंदर यहाँ पे कैसेट अंडरस्कोर डेटा के अंदर थंबनेल्स बनाया था ना हम लोगों ने तो वहाँ से एक कपड़ा क्योंकि वो पूरा प्रोसेसिंग करता है तो उस वजह से थोड़ा टाइम लेता है वो पहली बार जब कोई नया म्यूज़िक प्ले करता है तो वो सारी चीज़ें इस वजह से थोड़ा सा डिले होता है नहीं तो बाकी फिर तुम्हारा उस जोन में आ जाता ना तो फिर दिक्कत नहीं होता लाइक थंबनेल जनरेट करेगा सेव करेगा ये सारी पूरी चीज़ें होती हैं सो लेट मी शो यू हाउ टू क्रिएट अ प्लेलिस्ट राइट क्लिक किया ओके सो ये क्लिक किया एंटर योर प्लेलिस्ट नेम डब्ल्यू गैंग सबमिटेड एंड इन द डब्ल्यू गैंग आई विल ऐड दिस वन WN and the grammar and I will also add Jared Benjamin muscle memory right and if you come to your playlist section and you can see all the music listed here you can play the music simple
Okay, so one of the features which Cassette have is you can change this wallpaper up here. It is pretty simple. What you have to do is you have to come to your box. You have to come to Cassette underscore date folder and anything like GIF or PNG or any still image you can upload here. Upload it and rename it to wallpaper.gif or PNG or something. It should have wallpaper in it. When you will reload your Cassette, the wallpaper will be automatically took from box and it will be showed. As you can see, the wallpaper has been loaded.
And the best part, we are not done yet. It's just a beginning and we will keep adding more features and optimizing it and listen to your reviews, open GitHub reviews and we will check them out, we will fix the bugs, we will grow. But before it, I'm going to sleep 12 hours because I have a caffeine overdose.
And maybe I should finally clean my room.
रिश्ते निभाए पर तोड़े भी कई फैंस भी बोले ये बंदा है वही हु शॉट निकाला था गाना था सही झोटा बनाया फीम तो शुरू किया मैंने जीरो से अनरिलीज गाने सुने पब्लिक बीटों में मैडम जी चिल्लाती पगली वो भीड़ों में गर्मी चढ़ी बहुत आज इन कीड़ों में जाने माने गाने मेरे जाने माने गारे तेरे वादे भी नकारे करे शोज पे चला रहे बड़े शोज पे दोस्त भी जोश में बोलते बोलते सर भी खोलते सर जी बोलते थोड़ी गो हिट दैट फ्लिप दैट ऑल बैक डॉग टैग गॉट दैट मनी फ्रॉम स्टेट गॉट मी अ की की वी वी के वी वी शो हाउ